Hi, this is your third lecture for mathematics. We will discuss about rounding of the numbers. Now, this is the place value table, 1, 10, 100, 10,000, 1,000, 10,000 and lot. Now, we have to know how to round off the numbers. First, rounding off to the nearest 10. Now, look at here there are two values of the tens, 10 and 20. In between, there are the values between 10 and 20, 11, 12, 13 and so on. So, which is the nearest value of the tens? Here, if we discuss about 11, 12, 13, 14, these values are the nearest to the tens. And after that, look at 16, 17, 18 and 19, and these values are the nearest to the 20. But in between 15 is the nearest to the both tens, 10 and 20 both. But when we come to the in between the nearest two tens values, means 15 is the between 10 and 20. So, 15 is always count in the next tense, not to the previous one. When we find the nearest value of 15, the nearest value of 15 is 20, not 10. So, there are some rules for rounding of the numbers. First, to the nearest 10. Look at the table. We check the just before the place or just before which we count the nearest value. How? Here, the nearest 10. We have to find nearest 10. Look at the 10th place. Before the 10th place is 1st place. Check the 1st place digit. First rule is that check the 1st place digit. First rule, if 1's digit is less than 5, means less than 5 means 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. If 1's digit is less than 5, replace 1's digit by 0 and keep the other digits as they are. For example, look at 73. What is the nearest value of 73? 73, the nearest 10. The nearest 10 of the 73. Before the tens place, we check the ones place. What is the digit of ones place? The digit of ones place is 3. It's less than 5. If the ones digit is less than 5, replace this digit by 0. And keep the other digit as they are. If we replace 0, keep the other digit as they are. The tens digit is 7. So, tens digit remains 7. The nearest 10 of 73 is 7. The second rule, if 1 digit is 5 or more, 5 or more means 5, 6, 7, 8 or 9, then increase the 10th digit by 1 and replace 1 digit by 0. For example, look at the number 86. Check out the 1's digit. 1 digit is 6. It is greater than 5. So, increase the 10th digit by 1. The 10th digit is 8. So, increase the 8 by 1 means 9. And 1 digit is replaced by 0. So, nearest 10 of 86 is 90. This is rule of finding the nearest 10. The next step is the nearest 100. So, this is the rule of finding the nearest 100. Check the 10th digit number. Look at the place before 100 is 10. So, check the 10th digit number. The first rule, if 10th digit is less than 5 means are 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. If 10 digit is less than 5, replace 10 and 1 digit by 0 and keep other digits as there. For example, here the number 526, we have to find the nearest 100 of this number. First, check the 10 digit number. Okay, the 10 digit number is 2. This is less than 5. If the 10 digit is less than 5, then replace the 10 and 1 digit by 0 and keep the 100 or other digits as they are. Means the 100 digits is the same as they are and these two digits replace by 0. So the nearest 100 of 526 is 5. Second rule, if 10 digit is 5 or more, means 5, 6, 7, 8 or 9, increase 100 digit by 1. If the 10 digit is 5 or more, increase 100 digit by 1 and replace each digit on its right by 0. For example, this is the number 764. We have to round up to the nearest 100. Look at the 10th digit number. 10th digit number is greater than 5. So increase the 100 digits by 1. Here 100 is 7. So the next after 7 is 8. And replace the all the digits by 0 on its right. So 10th and 1 digit is replaced by 0. So the nearest 100 or 764 is 800. Okay. Now, nearest 1000. The same rule. First, look at the place before the 1000. It's 100. So check the 100 digits. If 100 digit is less than 5, means 0, 1, 2, 3, or 4. Then replace 100 tens and 1 digit by 0, means digit before the 1000. All the digits replace by 0 and keep the other digits as they are. For example, this is the number 7346. We have to find the nearest 1000 of this number. So before the 1000 place is the 100. Check out the 100 place digit is 3 less than 5. So replace all the digits from 100, 1000 and 100, 10s and 1s. Right? Before the 1000, all the digits replaced by 0. This digit is less than 5. So there are no change in the 1000 place digit. So the nearest 1000 or 7346 is 7000. Same, if the 100 digit is 5 or more, means if 100 digit is 5, 6, 7, 8 or 9, then increase 1000 digit by 1 and replace all the digits on its right by 0. For example, 5836. What is the nearest 1000 of this number? Check the digit before the 1000, means the 100 plus digit, this is 8, means this is greater than 5. So increase the 1000 digit by 1. This is 5, and we increase 5 by 1, we get 6, and replace all the digits after 1000 by 0. Means 100 tens and ones, all the places replaced by 0. The nearest 1000 or 5836 is 6000. Good. Now, come to the exercise 1D. Question number 1. We have to round out the numbers to the nearest 10. The first part of question 1. The nearest 10 are 36. So check out the number before the 10th place. It's 1's place and 1's place is 6. Means this is greater than 5. So increase the tenth place by 1 and replace the ones place by 0. When we increase the tenth place 3 by 1, we get 4, and the ones place is replaced by 0, mean the nearest 10 are 36 equal to 40. In the second, the nearest 10 are 173. The nearest 10, what is the 10th digit? 7. So check out the digit before the 10th digit. It's 1 digit and 1 digit is 3, which is less than 5. So replace the digit by 0. Means replace 1's digit by 0. And this is less than 5. So keep the 10th digit same. And the other digit means the 100 digit also 1. So nearest 10 of 173 is 170. Nearest 10 of 3869. We have to find nearest 10. What is the 10th place? 10th place is 6, and the place before 10th place is 1's place, and 1's place is 9. Means 9 is greater than 5. So why the 1's place is greater than 5? Increase the 10th place by 1. So 6 is increased by 1, you get 7, and replace the 1 digit by 0, and keep the other digits as they are, 3 and 8 are 7. The nearest 10 of 16,378. Check out the digit before the 10th place. The 1's place is 8, is greater than 5. So increase the 10th digit by 1. And 7 increase by 1, we get 8, and 1 digit by 0. And keep the other digits as they are, 1, 6, 3. It's 7. These are the nearest 10. In question number 2, we have to find nearest 100 of them. First, the nearest 100 of 814. Look at the place before 100 is 10th place, and 10th place is less than 5. 10th place is 1, and this is less than 5. So replace 10th and 1 both digits by 0, and keep the same other digits as they are. In the second, the nearest 100 of 1254. Look at the nearest 100. Check out the digit before 100 in the 10th place, and the 10th place is 5. If the 10th place is 5, increase the 100 digit by 1. So when we increase 2, we get 3, and keep the other digits 0. And I have to keep the digits as they. So 1254. The nearest 100 is 1300. In the next, the nearest 100 are 43,126. Look at the 100 is 1. Digit before 100 is 10th place. 10th place is 2 less than 0. Means 10th and 1 digit replaced by 0, and keep the other digits as they are. 43,100 is the nearest 100 of the digit. Look at the nearest 100 of 98,165. Look at the digit before 100 place 6 is greater than 5. So 100 digit increased by 1, we get 2. And other digits 0, keep the other digits at the left as they are. So 98,200 is the nearest 100 of the digits. Okay. Now, the next topic is estimation. Estimation is the nearest about nearest value of the any sum. Estimation means a guess of the any number. For example, in exercise 1B, for question number 5, here we have to estimate the sum 57 plus 34 to the nearest 10. So, first we find the nearest value of nearest 10 of both values. So, first we estimate the 57 and the 34 and then we find the sum of these two estimations. Now, the 57 is estimated to the nearest 10. The nearest value, nearest 10 of 57 is 60. 7, the nearest value of 34 is 30. And the required estimation is the sum of these two estimations. So, the estimation of 57 is 60 and the estimated value of 34 is 30. Sum of these two values, 60 plus 30 equal to 90. Now, if we have to estimate the sum to the nearest 100, question number 14, here 236 plus 689, and we have to estimate to the nearest 100. So, first we find the estimate or round off values of these two numbers. First, the 236 is estimated to the nearest 100 is 200, and 689 estimated to the nearest 100 is 700. So, required sum is 200 plus 700 means 900. 900 is the estimated sum of to the nearest 100. Next, estimation of difference of the values. In question number 26, here 678 minus 250. So, we have to estimate the difference. First, we find the estimated value of the given number. So, 678 is estimated to the nearest 100 is 700, and 215 to the nearest 100 is 200. So, required estimation is 700 minus 200 is equal to 500. This is the estimated value of the given numbers. Now, the next topic is estimation of the product and the question. In exercise 1E, here 38 into 63, we have to find the estimated value of these two numbers. So, first, 38 estimated to the nearest 10 is 40, and 63 estimated to the nearest 10 is 60. The required estimation is 40 into 60 means 2400. So, in the estimation of the quotient, same, we have to estimate the quotient 87 divided by 28. So, estimated quotient is equal to the nearest value of 87 is 90 and the nearest 10 of 28 is 30. So, estimated value of the number is 3. So, these are the estimation of product and the quotient. Okay.